Hello everyone, I'm Camille Tichadou and today I will present you a part of my PhD work about serpentinization processes and hydrogen production in the northwestern Pyrenees. Today I will particularly insist on the hydrogen production aspect. Serpentinization consists of the hydration of peridotite at temperature below 400 degrees. It produces hydrated phase-like serpentine. It is coupled to the oxidation of ferrous iron into ferric iron and the reduction of water into hydrogen gas. The hydrogen gas production is directly linked to the amount of ferric iron produced and its distribution over secondary minerals, which depends on the serpentinization conditions. In this study, we want to estimate the hydrogen budget in two massifs from the northwestern Pyrenees. The first one, Manteau, is a highly serpentinized massif limited by the north frontal Pyrenean thrust. The second massif, Eurdache, is localized at the termination of the Maillary thrust. It consists of serpentinite in the core of the massif, associated to ophicalcite, a carbonate-bearing serpentinite, exposed in two quarries in the southwest and southeast part of the massifs. As you can see as a left ternary plot, our peridotite have a high content of serpentine and magnetite, superior to 50%. However, in the right diagram, you can see that serpentinite from Eurdache and dark blue are magnetite-free, while Manteau peridotite and Eurdache ophicalcite have a magnetite content. Even if they don't have a magnetite content, which is the main carrier of ferric iron, serpentinite from Eurdache do have a bulk rock ferric iron content. This can be explained by the capacity of serpentine to bear ferric iron. To better evaluate the hydrogen budget, we thus need to determine the amount of ferric iron contained in serpentine. The serpentine iron content versus its oxidation states shows that iron in iron-rich serpentine, which is the case for serpentinite from Eurdache, is less oxidized than iron in iron-poor serpentine. We plot the contribution of serpentine and magnetite to the total ferric iron content. We can see that serpentinite from Eurdache have the higher ferric iron content. By coupling these results with the fraction of each secondary minerals, its iron content and its speciation, we can deduce the hydrogen production and showing that serpentinite from Eurdache have the higher production of hydrogen.